Welcome to the Dinosaur Review for Kids podcast. A show all about reviewing dinosaurs on a scale of 1 to 10 fossils before only the elite terrible lizards make it into the prehistoric cage match. This program is presented by the Stomp Chomp Roar Company and can be heard within all the rock layers across the planet. Grab your dinosaurs and your official scorecard because it's now time to dig for dinosaurs. Here's your Mesozoic host, Dinosaur Ranger Anthony.
Welcome, junior paleontologist. Are you ready to stomp westward towards California? Not for gold, silly Saurolophus, but for dinosaur fossils. Let's start our westward expansion on the Dinosaur Review for Kids podcast. Today's dinosaur species is native to the state of California and is also the state that I just so happen to be traveling to this Monday, April 4th, 2022. We are finally making our trip to Disneyland and Universal Studios after it was canceled back in 2020. We are super excited. My oldest daughter, Junior Ranger Cecilia, still doesn't know the big news, so we're super excited to tell her this weekend that we're traveling back to California to go see Disneyland, Universal Studios, the Aquarium of the Pacific, a few presidential museums. We're going to have so much fun. We're even going to the Tar Pits, the Natural History Museum of Los Angeles. It's just going to be so much fun, you guys. So this episode is going to be a little bit about a native species of dinosaur that comes from California. Now, before we jump into our review today, you guys, let's go over a little bit of dinopreneur news. As always, our Patreon club for the month of April, I just finalized our calendar, you guys. So our Zoom lessons or our virtual lessons, remember, you can join the Patreon club and take advantage of these virtual lessons over Zoom. So on Sunday, April 10th, we will be doing it on dinosaur eggs, the different types of dinosaur eggs. And then on Sunday, April 24th, we'll be doing a lesson on nocturnal dinosaurs, the kingdom of the night. So take advantage of those two virtual lessons with myself, Dinosaur Ranger Anthony. We're going to have so much fun. If you want to join, just look us up on patreon.com/stompchomproar. Now, a couple quick shout-outs, everybody. Happy birthday to Eden. We went and visited his birthday party last minute over the weekend, so we had tons of fun entertaining and educating all his friends and family members about prehistoric life. Also, shout-out to all the out-school learners that I've talked to over the last few days. I've been doing my junior paleontologist training class on out-school the last 4 days. Have met a ton of incredibly smart kids all about prehistoric life. So shout out to all you guys if you were one of my out-school learners. Also, shout out to Happy Face Preschool. We'll be visiting them later today and tomorrow on Thursday. So we're super pumped to come visit your preschool. Also, shout out to Wheeler Elementary. We'll be visiting them this Friday and doing our second prehistoric pep rally. Super excited to do this pep rally. And also, a happy birthday to Michael and Michael. We have two birthday parties this weekend, and they both happen to be named Michael. So super weird how that happens sometimes. So happy birthday to both of those Michaels. Now, you guys, let's grab our scorecard. Let's grab our pickaxes and our gold. I mean, our dinosaur fossils. It's time for our next review. Let me go ahead and pull up my scorecard. And remember, you can print off this scorecard for free on my website. Just go to stompchomproar.com, click on that Science Lab tab, and you can print off the official Dinosaur Review for Kids scorecard. So you can do your own dinosaur review, or maybe follow along with me, Dinosaur Ranger Anthony. So here we go. Let's get started. Let's dive right in. We're digging for gold today. We're talking about the Augustinolophus. The Augustinolophus. Now, this creature, this dinosaur, how did it get its name? Well, the name is after a family called the Augustines. So it's kind of a little bit about their family name or their last name, the Augustines, and its relation to the Saurolophus. So they kind of combined the Augustine last name with the Saurolophus creature or the duckbill dinosaur. Combine those two names and we get the Augustine Augustino Lofus. Super cool. I really love this name. Well, the Augustino Lofus, it's dinosaur order. It's an ornithischian, which means it's a bird-hipped dinosaur. And then it falls into that ornithopod suborder. Those are the herbivores. And then it falls into the hadrosaurids subfamily, and then the Saurolophinea. So that is its dinosaur order. It's a hadrosaur duckbill type dinosaur. Now, how big was the Augustino Lofus? Well, you guys, it is reaching 26 to 30 feet in length, or 8 to 9 meters. It's reaching up to 10 feet high, or 3 meters, and it can weigh as much as up to 3 tons. So again, 26 to 30 feet in length, or 8 to 9 meters, up to 10 feet high, or 3 meters, and up to 3 tons, or 6,000 pounds. So this is based on, you guys, we don't find very many fossils of the Augustino Lofus, and we'll talk about its fossils a little bit later on, but the size is based upon a reconstruction of only the skull. So they can see how big the skull is and do a reconstruction of the skull fossil, and they can take its measurements and be able to estimate how long its body was just by seeing its skull. So how fast was the Augustino Lofus? This creature, this hadrosaur, is coming in around, I believe, a little bit higher than 25 miles per hour. It's running on that bipedal stance, and then maybe getting down to a quadrupedal stance when it's getting all kinds of low-lying vegetation. So bipedal, walking on two legs, running on two legs. Quadrupedal, down on all four legs, maybe getting some of those cycad plants, low-lying ferns and mosses off the ground all along Pangaea. Now, what weapons, defense, or other characteristics did the Augustino Lofus have? Well, this creature, not to be confused with a Paraceralophus, that one has the huge head crest, or Augustino Lofus only has like a spike-like bony head crest atop of their 3-foot skull. So their head crest is a lot smaller than the Paraceralophus. It almost looks like a little spike, so it's very spike-like on top of their head. And their head, their skull is about 3 feet long. Now, they believe this head crest could have been maybe for maybe a little bit of defense or for mating. Maybe it had cool colors on it, or maybe even communication. Like we see our Paraceralophus, maybe they could make that foghorn-like sound through the tubes or the tunnels up in their head crest. So it could be very possible that our Augustino Lofus could have used something very similar. Now, this is a duck-billed dinosaur. When you look at their skull, it looks like the shape of a duck that we see walking around today. Now, the Augustino Lofus is our herbivore, as we mentioned. They're eating all kinds of vegetation, low-lying plants in their environment, and they have a spoon-shaped beak at the front. Now, their beak is toothless, so there's no teeth at the very front of their mouth, but in their cheeks, they have dental batteries, they call them. And it's a bunch of razor-sharp teeth. They believe up to 2,000 teeth. And in the very back of their jaws, new teeth would grow, and towards the front would be the old teeth that are rotting away. So they believe the hadrosaurs would be able to grow new teeth, and they would work their way towards the front until they eventually fell out and they rotted away. So about 2,000 teeth inside their cheeks right there in those dental batteries. The beak is toothless in the front. Now, they had a beaded reptilian-like skin all across the body of the Augustino Lofus, like we see in many of the other herbivores. No feathery evidence in these herbivores. They had a claws with those kind of mitten-like hands. Now, some scientists believe those mitten-like hands on our hadrosaurs could be more of a fossilization process, and they really didn't have that mitten-like hand when they were actually alive. They have that long, big tail at the back of their bodies to help counterbalance the rest of their body, their heavy skull. It helps like a scale or a teeter-totter. Helps them run very quickly. That tail is acting as a counterbalance. Now, our Augustino Lofus is probably living in herds like the rest of our hadrosaur-type dinosaurs. That's helping them be able to feed, nest, migrate together, and also, you got it, protection. Protection from the herd is going to be number one. That's going to be their biggest defense, is those herd numbers. Maybe up to 10,000 herd members. So super cool. I just love those hadrosaur dinosaurs, as you guys know from past episodes. Now, where did this dinosaur live, and how long did the Augustino Lofus Canolophus species live during the Mesozoic era. Well, the August Canolophus is coming in at about 70 to 65 million years ago during the late Cretaceous period, so it may have witnessed the KPG extinction event that eliminated all the dinosaurs. Now, they lived near the shores. Their fossils are found in marine rocks on the coastline, in the marine rocks in California, like I mentioned. They are native to California, found in the Moreno Formation in Fresno County. So they're going to be just a little bit north of where I'll be visiting here next week when we go to Los Angeles. So super cool. I love this dinosaur, the Augustinolophus. It is the state dinosaur of California. It was found in 1939 and 1943, and I believe it wasn't named till about 2014 because it finally became its own genus or species. At one time, they thought it was just Saurolophus fossils. So it became its own genus in 2014, became the state fossil of California, I believe, in 2017. So you guys, a quick recap about our Augustinolophus. It's 26 to 30 feet in length, so a little bit smaller than the 33 feet we see on the Parasaurolophus. Augustinolophus is up to 10 feet high. Our Parasaurolophus is getting to be about 16 feet high. So Augustinolophus is a much smaller hadrosaur type dinosaur. This one's also weighing up to 3 tons or 6,000 pounds. Now, I think it could run a little bit faster than the Parasaurolophus since it is a little bit more smaller, not as heavy. I think it's going to run a little bit faster than 25 miles per hour. The Augustinolophus has that spike-like bony head crest on top of their 3-foot skull, probably for mating and communication. I don't think they would have used it very much in defense, maybe in inner herd combat, possibly. They have that duck-billed beak, that toothless beak with all those dental batteries, up to 2,000 teeth, that reptilian-like skin, and they lived in those herds, so the herd is really going to protect them from all kinds of predators, and they lived during the late Cretaceous period. So you guys, where are we going to place our Augustinolophus on the official fossil scale? In an earlier episode, we gave Parasaurolophus a 6.0, so I believe it's only right that we put our Augustinolophus just a few notches below that. So here on our official results for the Dinosaur Review for Kids podcast, I'm going to give the Augustinolophus a 5.7. There we have it, a 5.7 for Augustinolophus. Still a very good score. I love these creatures. I love those hadrosaur duck-billed dinosaurs. They have really turned into some of my very favorite dinosaur species. Now, thank you guys all for digging for dinosaurs with me today. This species is also, like I mentioned, the state dinosaur of the state of California, and its fossils are kept at the Los Angeles County Natural History Museum, where I'll be making a quick stop this Monday. We are just so excited. Now, next Wednesday, you guys, I will be riding the Jurassic World ride at Universal Studios. There goes my Parasaurolophus right there. Like I mentioned, we're going to be riding the Jurassic World ride at Universal Studios next Wednesday, so I won't be uploading a podcast on April 6th. So wish me and my wallet good luck, because when I go to the Jurassic World gift shop, that wallet is going to be hurting for money, because I think I want to spend all my money at the gift shop at Jurassic World. Now, before we go today, a quick joke. What did Rex say to Woody after eating the toy soldiers? What did Rex say to Woody after eating a toy soldier? You got a friend in me. You got a friend in me. Toy Story. Does everybody love Toy Story? I hope I get to see a Rex there when we go visit Disneyland. Maybe even buy one from one of the gift shops. I don't have a Rex toy from Toy Story. So you guys, now after the first 6 episodes of season 3, we currently have the Ankylosaurus, that is the armored tank dinosaur, and the Megalosaurus, which is dinosaur fossil numero uno, at the top and in the next prehistoric cage match. Will another species within the next 3 episodes overtake those top scores and enter into the arena? Stay tuned, because we have an action-packed prehistoric cage match coming up in just 4 episodes. Now, you guys, my name is Dinosaur Ranger Anthony, the fabulous host of the Dinosaur Review for Kids podcast. And as always, keep digging for dinosaurs. We'll see you guys later.